So lately, people are getting creative with it. Like I've seen in Facebook groups, they're making new recipes with ambali. They are grinding ambali with fruits and nuts and all that. My question is it a good idea to agitate or like grind ambali because it's a probiotic food?
Yeah, they should not generate heat. That's the only precaution. Their recipes and procedures can do anything they want to, but should not generate heat, because when you generate heat above 36 degrees centigrade in situ, then many of the microbes start getting non-functional. Rather, they may go under a shock and become different. So it's better to not generate heat. Other than that, you can add whatever you want. So the recipe should keep in mind that they don't generate heat. That's as simple as that. Then you can do whatever you want with ambali. Yeah, that's great. But write a caution whenever you meet people. Tell them we will also try to. We have told that very clearly in ambali preparation. Yeah. Let magic. We have very clearly indicated. Sarla has made it very clear. Even a small kid can do that. But you are sacrificing the probiotic condition if you heat. That's it. And we have even told them you can heat, make it warm in a double water bath method, which does not kill the microbial activity. See, if you heat things slowly, it's just like a frog. If you take a frog and drop it in 100 degrees centigrade, it will jump out. But keep it in water, which is normal temperature, and heat it slowly to 100 degrees, the frog is fine. Okay. It will not jump out. The same thing. So you should not shock the microbes. If you are warming it slowly to a comfortable warmthness of your mouth, a lot of people don't like the cold thing, so they want warm. But you cannot go on heating beyond 36, 37 degrees centigrade. So if you have these two things completely under your control, then ambali is good.